Hey guys, Multi-Game Master 1 reporting in. Welcome back to my 100% Let's Play of Banjo-Kazooie. In the last part, we explored more of Grunty's lair and started exploring Treasure Trove Cove, pretty much going on a basic treasure hunt. And in this episode, we're going to continue our treasure hunt in Treasure Trove Cove. With me, I have my returning special guest, Pete the Crocodile. Pete, welcome back to the show.
Thank you! Hello, guys!
And now, without further ado, let's get the treasure hunt underway. So the first thing I want to pick up is this mumble token back here. And let me just adjust my microphone for a second. All right, there we go. And there's an extra honeycomb piece over there, but unfortunately, we have to get past him.
Me. Snacker smells tasty dinner. Stay just there.
You know what? You need to die, Snacker.
I'll be back.
I dare you to come towards me.
Yippee! Snacker's guest dessert, too!
It takes a few shots with eggs in order to defeat him. And I just thought I'd start off the episode by killing him because he is annoying and I wanted payback for him chomping me at the beginning. Well, maybe not the beginning of the last episode, but like the beginning of the level from the last episode. Anyway, so continuing right along, so we got the mumble token and the empty honeycomb piece back there, and now we're going to go onto the ship. I'm not sure exactly what the name of the ship is called, but here's Captain Blubber on it.
Ahoy there, I'm Captain Blubber, and I lost me treasure when me ship crashed.
Find it then, Blubber Guts.
Arr, but I can't swim, can you help me, an old sea hippo?
Sure, we'll find it for you. Okay, so now what we have to do is find the gold bars that he's missing from his treasure collection. We're gonna start down here in the ship.
Oh my god, where's my forks? Where's my forks? Damn it, where's my forks? No! Oh god. Oh well.
Is everything alright, Pete?
Yep, just missing me forks.
Okay. Well, here's the gold bar.
Boy there! I be Blubber's treasure!
That was easy.
Yeah, that was our first piece of gold.
Hey, that be half of me gold!
Half of your gold? Jeez, you could have told us that from the start.
Sorry.
Anyway, the second stash of gold is in this side of the ship. You just want to go on the starboard side, I think it is, of the ship, and just swim to the gold bar in order to pick it up. Now we'll take this back to Captain Blubber, because he really wants the gold bad, because he's greedy, like any other pirate. And now, two gold bars collected.
Me treasure! Thank you, me hearties! Take this reward! I'm off to spend!
And with that, we get another jiggy. Gold exchange for gold, huh?
Yeah.
Now we're gonna make our way up here because, as you guys remember from the last episode, we saw some things up here, like these notes, and if we get to the top of the crow's nest, even though it's not really much of a crow's nest, here's another Jinjo. And now let's go ahead and fly over to that big chest over there because it has something valuable that we need.
But then again, aren't Jiggy's like priceless? And then the gold
is obviously gold. This be Gruntilla's booty. Touch it if you dare. I guess in a way they would be valueless or priceless.
That golden treasure was for me. Now harder still, the game will be.
You mean you were actually gonna make it easy for us, Grunty? Yeah, right.
Well,
wait, what's that sound? Snacker. Snacker. No. No.
Cheese and crackers. No. Just wait.
Die.
There.
Die. It takes a few shots with eggs in order to defeat him.
Stop pooping on me! Coffee and mints!
Okay,
right,
that's why I'm shooting eggs at you. How about that? Die!
That belated scream.
Okay. Let's see, where can we go next? How about... I know one place we could go to. We can go on to Shark Food Island over there and pick up that extra life. And I sure hope Snacker doesn't show up.
You better not get that extra life!
Too late, already got it. And I see something else out in the distance as well. It looks like an extra honeycomb piece. We'll get that as well. Yep, it's all the way out there.
Now I'm really going to bite your neck off.
And here's another mumble token back here. Now swimming for the crate with the extra honeycomb piece on top. Certainly hope Snacker doesn't show up.
You just wait till I respawn.
Uh-oh. You know what, Snacker? Get lost.
Aw, I just want to be loved.
Yeah, right. You love biting food.
Yeah, I do.
That doesn't make you friendly.
Everyone tastes like barbecue ribs.
Barbecue ribs. That sounds pretty good right now. Anyway, the thing about the chest with the sharp teeth, you don't want to touch the teeth, otherwise you will take damage. And here's an extra life right there.
It's kind of funny, because I didn't even find that as a kid. Like, wow.
Yeah, you learn something new every day, huh? And we have some more notes right here. And now let's make our way to the top of here. I have a feeling that we'll find something valuable up here.
Yeah, like your death!
Or maybe this giant X.
Or maybe not.
Clearly X marks the spot, but we don't have a shovel. I wonder what would happen if we did this. Follow the clues if you're looking for gold. So as we ground pound on the X, it transforms into an arrow, and we just want to follow it all over the Treasure Trove Cove in order to find us some treasure. Of course, it's not going to be as easy as you guys think it will be. You guys will just have to see. Anyway, before we continue, I want to explore the back of this island here. And I can't believe I wasted so many eggs taking down Snacker. That stupid shark. He deserved to pay. Anyway, back
to the way, we're only 8 minutes in, so nice progress, dude.
What was that?
We're only 8 minutes in.
8 minutes in? Alright, cool. But what I plan to do is to wrap everything up in Treasure Trove Cove as fast as I can.
Yeah. Sweet.
And I don't care how long it takes me, I'm gonna get this done. Okay, now make our way up the stairs. We have more notes, we have a beehive. Don't really care about it.
Just to confirm, you've picked up every Mumbo token thus far, correct?
I think so. I'll have to go back and check later, as soon as the recording's over. And here's another enemy of mine, but it doesn't seem to be paying any attention to us, so we can just ignore it. And here's a Jiggy down here. So we're up to 6 Jiggies.
Yeah, he's pretty much like a pond skater. He can't, like, sink and chase you under the water, which is pretty cool.
Yeah, because the water is a lot more dense than the mine itself.
He's fatty.
Yeah, basically. Anyway, I'm just gonna sneak around this mine.
You better not touch my eggs!
Oh crud. Okay. I grabbed your eggs. What are you gonna do about it? Nothing.
I will set the crab on you. Oh, too late.
Too late, the crab is already dead. Oh, by the way, Pete, you were asking in the last episode if there are wops around this hive. There aren't any at the moment, but, well, I won't spoil things, but the fans will just have to wait and see what happens if you destroy too many hives.
Yeah.
Anyway, if we go over here, we have another X. We'll slam on top of that.
So regardless of if there's any, like, pests outside hives, if you break so many, something bad's gonna happen.
Yeah, you'll just have to wait and see. That's why I prefer not to destroy so many hives. And we have some more eggs here. I thought these had a gold feather. Well, whatever.
Yeah.
Eggs are valuable, and I'll find more gold feathers. Oh, and I forgot these notes on the palm trees over here. Well, I'll come back for those later. Right now, I really want to get the treasure.
It's a bit like the banana bunches in DK, Donkey Kong 64. The trees, you generally miss the ones on the trees, which kind of sucks, but yeah.
Oh yeah, those small banana bunches.
Yeah.
They can be relatively small and maybe even easy to miss.
Yeah, and the red of this doesn't help.
Alright, so moving right along. Now I'll come back for those later. Anyway, Let's now use the shock jump disc path in order to get a few things, such as this mumble token. Jump over here to get some notes. It's like we're skipping along a pit or something. What'd you say, Pete?
I didn't say anything, but couldn't you, like, basically, you know when you're shock jumping, couldn't you, like, land on the floor and then bounce all the way up again? That looks pretty fun.
You actually can. Check this out.
Yeah! Oh, that feels awesome.
Anyway, here's where the X stops, it looks like. Let's go ahead and slam on top of it as soon as I get rid of this crab. And now it's marked with the question mark. Ha, you'll never find me now. So,
oh, really?
Now it's marked with a question mark, and I wonder where it is that we need to go in order to pick up the treasure. I wonder. Well, we'll solve more into the mystery later. Anyway, let's just use the shock jump disc pads in order to reach that jiggy up there that me and Pete can clearly see.
Put it this way, you don't need to be a rocket scientist to find out where the treasure chest is.
Well, Pete, you're gonna have to help me and the fans on this one. Did you pay attention to any certain spots in which we could find the treasure? Anywhere?
I can't hear you, Skype's messing up. What?
Sorry,
What'd you say?
Do you know any places in which we could find the eggs?
The eggs?
Oh, wait a sec. Is this the eggs? Pete, is this the eggs?
Yeah.
Well, let's try slamming on top of it. There's the treasure.
Yikes! Please open me gently!
I don't think so.
Lol.
And there's the jiggy after that long treasure hunt. And we owe it all to Pete for pointing out where the X was. Thank you, Pete! That's why you should go ahead and subscribe to Pete, because he is awesome like that.
And that actually took like 3 years of solid like research, so please leave a like on this video, it does help.
Yeah, and also subscribe to Pete and leave some likes for his videos as well.
Oh yes, Toucan.
Alright,
87, that's pretty good.
Yeah, 87 notes. Hopefully I got all the notes that was so far. I think I'm pretty good. We'll check the totals at the end.
Wasn't there a palm tree near the start that you missed notes on? Unless the rest of the notes...
Those are feathers. Right. Those are just feathers.
Okay, well then I guess, yeah. They're above. Yeah.
Alright, let's fly over to this part of the rocky wall over here. Up the stairs we go, and we're at the base of the lighthouse. As you can... barely see up there. And we have a bunch of things to collect around here.
I know why those clams like the eggs so much, because they taste like Kazooie's poop.
We haven't even covered the clams taking...
No, yeah. You should show off.
You've been awarded a gamer pick. Lucky you.
Yeah, show off.
Gamer picks come every time you complete something in the game. And like I said before, I'm playing the Xbox 360 version, so you might see plenty of those. But, in a Nintendo 64 version, you don't see any of that.
Aw, oh, but Mom, I wanted to see them steal the eggs.
But I don't want to lose my eggs and feathers. Come on.
Meh! You got so many anyway.
Alright. If you get close to the clam and take damage, not only will you lose health...
Look! Nice snacks for Yum Yum.
Okay, so that clam is a Yum Yum, and every time you run into him, you'll not only take damage, like I am, but you'll also lose one egg and one feather, so take extreme care around him.
He only likes the eggs because it says that Kazooie is Kazooie's poop. I couldn't even say Kazooie for a second now, oh my god. Wow.
Oh, Pete, you're such a killer. Anyway, here's a grunty switch right here. Ground pounding on top of it gives us a bonus jiggy outside the map. Now let's travel up the lighthouse. If I can break down the door, there we go. And here are the remaining notes. All 100 notes collected. Don't need to read that because he says the same thing in all worlds. And here's the last jiggy. And that's all 10 jiggies collected for this world. Now to check the totals. So right now we have 100 notes, 10 jiggies, and 2 empty onion comb pieces, so our work here is done.
And it's only been 16 minutes!
16 minutes? Wow. That's amazing.
Overkill much?
You know what?
Yeah, pick up that jiggy and then we can call it quits.
Or I could do something else. I don't know. I'll think about it as we go.
Okay.
And I didn't want to have to destroy that hive, but I needed the help. And before we go, I'm just going to pick up one red feather that I lost from that yum yum. Or that clam. Pete! You mean your jokes? You really like to act like the enemies, don't you?
Yeah, yeah.
You're funny, Pete. Okay, so out of Treasure Trove Cove we go, and the bonus jiggy that we activated can be found if we jump on top of this cannon and take down this guy.
Oh!
And there's the bonus jiggy.
Yeah.
So that's 3 jiggies for Grunty's lair and 7 left. I have no idea where the others are, but so far we've been hitting a lot of Grunty switches, so I think those may have something to do with it. Anyway, up there is another note door up that slope. Let's see, we have 200 and we need 180 to bypass it, but we're not gonna cover that just yet. Actually, I want to go back for a moment just to check something out.
Ah, my eye's hurting! Ah!
Are you okay, Pete?
Oh wait, wrong part of the game. Whoa!
And here's a shock jump disc pad, and let's see what we have up there. Well, we do have something up there, but I wonder what it is exactly. We could potentially use the shock jump disc pad in order to find it. However, I think that's all we're going to do for this episode, so...
You killed your...
I'm sorry, Pete, but I'd like to leave a surprise for everyone. Anyway, unfortunately, I'm going to have to leave you guys with a cliffhanger and tell you guys that that is the end of this episode. So in the next part, we're going to use the shock jump disc pad in order to find out what's up there and hopefully gain entrance to the next world of interest. So until next time, I'm Multigame Master 1.
And I'm Pete the Crocodile! Oh, and leave what you think about the thumbnails for the series in the description. It'll be awesome to hear your feedback. Thank you!
Oh yes, Pete the Crocodile made the custom thumbnails for me. They're totally awesome. And like Pete said, if you could leave a comment for what you think about the thumbnails right now, that would be totally great. And also subscribe to his channel and give likes on his videos. He's working on Pokemon series and Ratchet and Clank. And Pete, before we end the episode, do you have anything else you want to say?
I really want some McDonald's right now.
You know what I want, Pete?
Toodles.
You know what I want, Pete?
Huh?
I want to has cookie.
Ooh, I got plenty of those.
I can't wait to get my hands on the cookie. Anyway, that's all for this episode, and we will see you guys later.
Peace.